Merci. Bonjour à tous. Hello everyone. Merci d'être des nôtres. Nous venons de participer ensemble à un sommet très productif avec nos partenaires européens. C'est toujours un grand plaisir de m'entretenir avec le président Michel et la présidente von der Leyen. En tant qu'amis et alliés, le Canada et l'Europe partagent des priorités communes. Plus que jamais, il faut continuer de travailler ensemble pour relever les différents défis devant nous. On a abordé divers sujets, notamment la pandémie et l'importance de rebâtir nos économies tout en faisant croître la classe moyenne. On a aussi discuté de notre lutte contre les changements climatiques, de notre collaboration en ce qui concerne les nouvelles technologies et de notre engagement à défendre nos valeurs communes comme la démocratie, les droits de la personne, l'égalité entre les sexes et la primauté du droit. Mais avant de parler de notre important travail avec l'Union européenne, j'aimerais dire quelques mots sur les autres rencontres des derniers jours. As you know, over the weekend, I was at the G7 in Cornwall with Ursula and Charles. As we continue the fight to end COVID-19 for good, we took a strong stance on major issues, including on access to vaccines, climate change, and global education. Yesterday, I took part in the NATO summit, along with our allies here in Brussels. The alliance is united and committed to continuing its important work on national and international security. We all agreed that we need to continue to adapt to new security challenges, including climate change and cyber threats. Our world is at a unique moment in history, and not only because of this pandemic. We must stand united. I'm encouraged by the collaboration I've seen between our friends and allies this week and during my meeting with the European Union. Our priorities are clear. Together, we must end this pandemic, rebuild our economies, and keep our people safe. Rebuilding our economies means thinking about the future. With EU partners, we talked about what we can do to build a cleaner economy for years to come. To begin with, in order to continue creating good, green jobs for the middle class, we must secure supply chains for critical minerals and metals that are essential for things like electric car batteries. That's why Canada and the EU are launching the Strategic Partnership on Raw Minerals. This new partnership is focused on securing the supply of these critical minerals, all while creating and supporting good jobs. Of course, we can't talk about supply chains without also talking about trade agreements. On that front, Canada and the EU are continuing our partnership under CETA to create opportunities for workers and businesses alike on both sides of the Atlantic. During our summit, we advanced our work to adopt a mutual recognition agreement that would simplify border procedures while enhancing security measures. This agreement will further speed up the flow of trade between Canada and the EU and contribute to the safety and security of all Canadians. We know that we've worked very hard together, the Europeans and Canada, over the past number of years, even as other countries were slightly more protectionistic. We were able to get many, many things done during an uncertain time on the global stage, which led us to strong advances for our citizens, for our economies, advances that we are continuing to build on today as we move forward at an even accelerated pace. Our government will continue to ensure all Canadians benefit from these progressive trade deals, including farmers, small and medium-sized business owners, women entrepreneurs, and the middle class. That's what Building Back Better is all about, an economy that leaves no one behind. And at the heart of that more resilient economy is climate change. Les changements climatiques et la perte de biodiversité sont des menaces existentielles. En plus de continuer nos efforts pour atteindre la carboneutralité d'ici 2050, le Canada et l'Union européenne vont renforcer leur collaboration pour développer des mesures et des technologies qui feront en sorte que la transition énergétique soit équitable pour tous. Parce que la santé de notre économie et la santé de notre planète sont liées. Plus on va créer de bons emplois verts, plus on va permettre à nos enfants respirer de l'air propre. Et pendant qu'on travaille pour réduire nos émissions, On doit aussi en faire plus pour protéger nos terres et nos océans. On parle souvent d'une économie plus verte, mais il ne faut pas oublier de parler d'une économie plus bleue aussi pour nos océans. À ce sujet, avec l'Union européenne, on va lancer le Forum de partenariat maritime qui aura pour but d'améliorer la collaboration entre les entreprises, les gouvernements et les autres partenaires afin de mieux protéger nos océans. On veut également s'assurer que notre agriculture soit plus durable. C'est pourquoi, suite à ce sommet, on va lancer une série d'initiatives qui aidera à informer et à faire la promotion d'une agriculture plus propre auprès des agriculteurs, de producteurs et d'autres organisations. On s'engage tous à continuer de prendre des mesures concrètes pour protéger notre environnement parce que notre santé et notre sécurité en dépendent. When it comes to health and safety, job one remains ending this pandemic. And as we do that, we have to continue strengthening our health systems for today and for the future. To support pandemic prevention, preparedness, and response, we will launch the Canada-EU Dialogue on Health. This will help Canada and Europe share more information, identify emerging health threats, and work together to keep people healthy, including through mental health support. And on the subject of the pandemic and vaccines, I want to pick up on what both Ursula and Charles talked about and say thank you. Thank you not just to European leaders, but to workers across Europe who've been getting the world through this pandemic by producing life-saving vaccines. Canada's friendship and close alliance with Europe is certainly something that we have counted on, but we will continue to work together to make sure that in the future, Canada continues to be a strong partner to get us all around the world through pandemics like this. Whether it's creating jobs or ending the pandemic, whether it's making our economies more competitive in the digital world or standing up for our shared values around the globe, together, Canadians and Europeans will continue to build a better future. Alors qu'on s'apprête à rebâtir suite à la pandémie, le partenariat entre le Canada et l'Union européenne est plus fort que jamais. Que ce soit suite au sommet d'aujourd'hui ou suite aux autres sommets de la semaine, je suis optimiste quant à notre volonté commune de créer un monde plus propre, plus inclusif et plus sécuritaire. On a encore beaucoup de défis devant nous, mais on va continuer de travailler ensemble pour les relever. Merci beaucoup, les amis. Merci beaucoup, tout le monde.